This is DM3, Yamaha's new series of compact digital mixing consoles that simply let you do more. I've already guided you through the fader banks and the rear panel connections in previous videos. Now, I'm going to talk you through the input channel settings. DM3 can both keep it simple for beginners and provide enough features to keep professional sound engineers satisfied. Let's begin with the home screen. Touch any parameter and it can be adjusted with the touch and turn knob. Touch the screen again to see a more detailed view of the audio process, such as EQ, dynamics, or input settings. In the input screen, you can see the GainFinder. Working kind of like a guitar tuner, it highlights the ideal signal level for the mixer, which will minimize noise, while avoiding overload and clipping. Notice there's always a digital gain available, so inputs from USB or Dante can be adjusted where necessary. The EQ screen provides a high-pass filter for inputs 1 to 16 and a 4-band parametric EQ for all channels. For channels that don't have a dedicated HPF, the low band can be converted from a shelf to a bell or HPF. Likewise, the high band can always be converted to a shelf, bell, or low-pass filter. The touchscreen can be used effectively for editing the EQ curves. Pinch for Q. And notice that all bands can sweep through the whole frequency range. If you swipe the screen from the right edge, you reveal shortcuts for copy and paste, gain flat and default, as well as quick access to a library packed with settings suited to popular microphones, instruments, and voices. Got a singer with a Sennheiser E835 mic? Perfect. Got a saxophone with a Shure SM57? No problem. There are also plenty of these QuickPro presets for Audio Technica and Audix mics. And they can set the whole channel, including input gain, channel name, and icon, dramatically speeding up your prep time and getting you ready for sound sources you may not be so familiar with. We also have the one knob EQ mode, made popular by Yamaha's TF series. Set the EQ curve and then activate intensity mode to provide one simple more or less slider. Or choose vocal mode to create the kind of EQ curve a professional sound engineer would instinctively shape for a live vocal performance. Each input has a noise gate or ducker available in the Dynamics 1 processor. Use the gate to cut background noise while a microphone is on but not active. Use the ducker on a background music channel. Select any other channel as the key in source, which will reduce the music level while an announcement is made. Every input and output channel is equipped with a compressor as Dynamics 2. This can be used to subtly smoothen the sound, or as a hard limiter, or something in between for musical creativity. If you're not sure how to use all the parameters, but want to give it a try, use the one knob mode. This sets all the parameters to a useful starting point. Then, as you turn it up, the signal gets louder and more punchy. If you reach the point where it seems like the sound is beginning to lose energy, you've probably taken the compression too far and wind it back a bit. Even when you're not viewing the dynamic screens, you can keep an eye on the gain reduction meters shown in the channel name display. Useful for the more experienced operators who will create the right balance between punchy and smooth sound characteristics. Every input channel is also equipped with a delay. You could use this to time align different sources and to make sure you have lip sync with video. Select whether to adjust the delay by frames, distance, or time. Push and turn for fine tuning. There's a lot of detail within the DM3 series, but the beauty is that you can get it set up and saved by an experienced operator and then protect the settings with a password, so they don't get altered by mistake. In the next video, we'll take a closer look at the output channels and internal effects processes. Again, they're simple enough for starters, yet powerful enough for professionals. DM3 series lets everyone do more.